We've got two out of our three asynchronous requests working. Let's get some Wikipedia articles about the page to show up. We're on the MediaWiki API page because Wikipedia is run by MediaWiki. And looking through this page, you'll actually find you don't need an API key. However, making normal JSON requests to Wikipedia would result in a cross-origin or a cross-site error because Wikipedia servers forbid cross-origin requests. There are several ways we can make this request to Wikipedia. One would be to set the origin and content type headers on the request, and then Wikipedia would allow it. Or we can just use JSONP. In our example, we'll be using JSONP. A JSONP request is a somewhat convoluted trick that involves the server wrapping the response inside a function to get injected when it actually gets back to the client. But luckily, if this sounds confusing, don't worry, jQuery actually makes it pretty easy. To make a JSONP request, we'll use the more robust .AJAX method. In fact, the .getJSON method we were using before was actually just an abstraction of the .AJAX method, which is incidentally also an abstraction of an asynchronous JavaScript request. For this quiz, use the .AJAX method to collect data from a Wikipedia endpoint. Let's take a look at the structure of the finished page. We start off with a Wikipedia container that has all the links, and then inside of it we have this unsigned list with an ID of Wikipedia links. Going through the unsigned list, we see just a couple list elements, and then within each list element we simply have an A tag with a link to Wikipedia. Each A tag, of course, contains the title of the Wikipedia article within it. And like you did before, for this quiz you'll need to properly append each Wikipedia article to the page. You'll need to include a few parameters inside your AJAX request. There will, of course, be a URL. You'll need to include a data type. Notice, too, in the signature that we don't have an optional success function parameter. Instead, you'll have to set it as a property. Make sure your success parameter is set to a function that you want to run when the request is returned successfully. To start off, you'll fire off a JSONP request using $.ajax. And then into $.ajax, you'll pass a settings object that will include a parameter for data type and a parameter for success. Once you get the response, iterate through it, and then present articles on the page, and they should end up inside the unsigned list with the ID of Wikipedia links. When you're done, check this box.